activate the presence of the Most High. Father, we thank you, we worship and exalt you, Jesus. Let us give you the fruit of our lips. Let us thank you for all that you have done. Let us thank you for all that you have yet to do. Thank you because you are standing today. Thank you because the situation of Nigeria has not weighed you down. Has not kept you where you don't want to belong. Let us thank him. Exalt his holy name. Father, we worship and exalt him of glory. We give you all the praise, Most High. We thank you because you have not forgotten us. We thank you because you have not forgotten us. We thank you because you have not forgotten us.
name of the Lord. It's time for our congregational prayer. We are going to be praying in line with the blood of Jesus. I want you to follow me with me with this scripture, and we are going to be praying. I want to read two scriptures that we are going to be praying. 2 Kings chapter 3. 2 Kings chapter 3. I want you to follow me on something about the blood. 2 Kings chapter 3. I read verses 26 and 27. And when the king of Moab saw that the battle was too sore for him, I want you to take note, the battle was too sore for him, he took with him 700 men that drew swords to break through even the kingdom of Edom, but they could not. Take note, the battle was too sore for him, he took his armies, they could not still what? Break through. But take note of something. Verse 27, then he took his eldest son that should have reigned in the stead and offered him for a burnt offering and the war. And there was great indignation against Israel, and they departed from him and returned to their own what? Land. That's on the negative side, that he slew his son. He offered a sacrifice of the blood. And what happened? What his armies could not do, he achieved. That's on the negative side. Come with me to 1 John chapter 2. 1 John chapter 2. I read verses 1 and 2 as well. My little children, this is right I unto you, that ye sin not. And if any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteousness, the righteous. Verse 2, and he is the propitiation for our sins, and not for our sins only, but also for the sins of the whole world. He said we have an advocate in Jesus, who is the propitiation. I'm not preaching or neither am I teaching, but what is propitiation? Propitiation is, you know, something we do, you know, to appease something, to appease somebody. Jesus became the appeasement of God for man to regain favor from God, for man to receive eternal life. Jesus became that thing that was sacrificed. And we are going to go on the platform of the blood of Jesus that was sacrificed for the sins of the world, to regain our nation, to regain our lives, to regain the church of God. So this morning you are going to lift up your voice. In one word, say, Father, I thank you for the blood that was shed on the cross of Calvary. Lift up your voice and thank the Lord for that blood that was shed on the cross of Calvary. Jesus became our propitiation. He became the sacrifice. He became the appeasement. He became the sacrifice, the one and only sacrifice accepted by the Lord for the redemption of man, for your redemption, for my redemption, for the redemption of our nation Nigeria. Lift up your voice and say, Father, we thank you for the blood that was shed on the cross of Calvary. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, blessed Redeemer. In Jesus' name, we are giving thanks. We are going to pray for Nigeria. We are going to stand. We are going to say, Father, look at the blood of the cross of Calvary and save our nation Nigeria, because it became the propitiation. In Mesha, the king of the Moab will gain victory by sacrificing, you know, by will stop a plague will stop the war by sacrificing so how much more the blood of the Lord Jesus. So lift up your voice and say, Father, we come unto you on the platform of the blood of Jesus. Save Nigeria in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray. I don't know what you want God to save Nigeria from, but lift up your voice and pray. Lord, save our nation. Restore our nation. Let Nigeria come to your favor books again. In the name of Jesus, save us from banditry. Save us from insecurity. Save us from every evil that plagues us. Because we come before your presence by the reason of the blood of the Lamb. By the reason of the blood of Jesus this morning. In the name of Jesus, let it be so. In Jesus' name we pray. You are going to pray for yourself. When the blood was laid as sacrifice, man regained eternity. He said, in him was life, and the life was the light of men. In him was life, and the light was the light of men. When Jesus left hell, when he left Hades, he came forth and said, I give unto you the keys of the kingdom. I give unto you the keys of hell. You are going to lift up your voice. You are going to say, Father, by the reason of the blood of Jesus, now mention those things that you want God to intervene in. Because Jesus became the propitiation that the favor of God will turn to you and turn your situations around because of the blood of Jesus. All because of the blood. All because of the blood. Rapas ande kasuta menas abdole bobobosa rande kosinas abdadei rabadadadabosata rekadabosipalika hata inapara degedebosa rabadadabokobokosode. The blood of Jesus rabokosu rabadadababokosutia. In the name of Jesus rahande shande didadabosa. In Jesus' name we pray. We are going to lift up our voice. We are going to say, Father, because of the blood of Jesus, let your favor rest upon us in this service. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and begin to pray. When the Lord favors you, he tells you that your breakthroughs are short. Your breakthroughs are short because of the blood of Jesus. We come on the platform of the blood this morning. Lira kamba bada bokosia, lira teke tebo supra bada boko bosome legede. When we were praying during prayer revolution, he said there's a Passover. I don't know whatever your circumstances are, but there is a Passover because of the blood of the Lamb. Because of the blood of Jesus, there is a Passover. Lepra Kandesa, approach the throne of grace because of the blood of the Lamb. Because of the blood of the Lamb. Because of the blood of the Lamb. Rakabos in Abasidia, in Akarusia, Brando Gosena Shande, Lera Pocoscoto Lobosutiande, Renanabo Sande. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen.
Quickly, let's look through our daily positive confession. The scripture today is taken from Psalm 126 and verse 3, the New Living Translation. Yes, the Lord has done amazing things for us. What joy! The Lord has done amazing things for us. What joy! What are we going to be saying to the ears of our Father? We are going to say, today,
today
I enter his gates
with praise
and his courts with thanksgiving. I step into abundance of thanks offering. Reasons to always rejoice shall never cease in my life. In Jesus' name. Turn into prayer. Thank you, Jesus. Glory be to your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Father, we thank you because it is so. Because you always have respect unto our prayers. We return all the glory and adoration to you. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. With the joy of the Lord, let's put our hands together as we bring up stage for the administration, the best choir on the face of the earth, the true worshipers choir. Put your hands together for them.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. We're happy to be here in the presence of the Lord because our God is a God of breakthrough. He said to do wonders in our lives. The Lord said we will not be forsaken or receive begging bread. The Lord will not allow us to do that in the name of Jesus. So we're going to minister a song to your soul this morning that the Lord is going to do that new thing. If he's done it before, he can do it again. Hallelujah. How many of us believe that he can do it again? The Lord is a child of praise. Hallelujah. Thank you.
about you, Lord. Fire you, Lord. Favor you. Lord, this face to shine upon you, the Lord. Be merciful and gracious unto you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank God for yet another opportunity and privilege to be in God's presence, to be blessed of God, to receive of God, and to be impacted of God. And we thank God for, you know, everything that He's done, even starting from the prayer revolution. I want to encourage as many as can come early to please make sure they come and participate in the prayer revolution. It's always a glorious time to pray. It's intercessory prayer. You pray situations and circumstances, and then you pray for yourself. And sometimes God decides to visit us even to bless us. And I'm sure that everyone who has been constantly coming will have a testimony, or always have testimonies, or always enjoy that time. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We're going to continue from, you know, where we stopped last Sunday, looking at it from some other dimensions. But let us pray before we go and dive into the word.
Receptive to your word. Lord, make our hearts, O God, the heart of flesh. Let it not be heart of stone, O God, that we may receive your word, we may process it with faith, we may run thereby, and we may profit therein. In the name of Jesus. Every wandering spirit, every spirit that buys themselves, every spirit that tries the power of God, we hold in captivity. We ask that only Jesus be glorified here. Thank you, Father, for you. Anoint my tongue to speak your word. Anoint our ears to hear your word. And at the end, let your name be glorified. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
And the saints shouted,
Hallelujah.
God bless you, God bless you. So last Sunday,
Sunday, if you remember, we were talking about the glory and the lifter of our hearts, that Jesus is the glory and the lift of our hearts. That is to say, we may be going through, indeed, we are going through, indeed, particularly those of us who are in Nigeria, living in Nigeria, or Nigerians, there's a lot we are dealing with, we are contending with. We are contending with so many things, all the arsenals are arrayed against us, as it were. We are dealing right now with insecurity. We are dealing with COVID. We are dealing with, lack. We are dealing with economic depression. We are dealing with unemployment. We are dealing with, business downturn. We are dealing with so many things. And, so we're dealing with the even survivor. Hello? Are you still here? We're having to deal with survivor. Do I have a witness? Is there anybody that is living in Nigeria that understands what I'm talking about?
Yes, sir.
Can you relate to what I'm saying?
Yes, sir. Sure.
Because you guys, the way you're looking at me is as maybe you guys are a planet Mars or something. Everybody, nobody is spared from this issue we have to contend with in Nigeria. In the very minimum, if you are not contending with anything else, you are contending with the insecurity. Just this morning. A brother was sharing with me how broad daylight, I don't know whether they are cultists, whether they are groups, whatever they are, that they've been like terrorizing that environment, and unfortunately innocent people, suffering, they are suffering. Some people have lost their lives, either stray bullets and stuff like that. And I was asked, I said that, so does it mean you cannot go about your normal duties? How do you now begin to say, because there might be danger, you're not going to go out? Well, you have to go out, right? You have to go out. Because if you don't go out, hunger will kill you at home. You have to go out and look for what to eat. But there's so much insecurity. And to compound it, our law enforcement agencies are not helping matters. So we are dealing with all of these things. And we saw last Sunday all the things that we are having to deal with. And on top of that is the fact that even in our personal space, it will appear that things are not working as they should. Things may not necessarily have happened or are not happening the way we desire them. And we saw that even whilst all of these things and turmoils are on, God has a plan and purpose for us. And we read so many scriptures that establish the fact that God has thoughts about us. Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 11, that God has thoughts about us. We read Isaiah chapter 49, verse 15 and 16, that God, because we remain in God's thoughts, He has not forgotten us. We read Hebrews chapter 13 and verse 5 that says that God has not forgotten or forsaken us. He has promised never to leave us or forsake us. We read Isaiah chapter 43 and verse 2 that says that God has not forgotten His promise towards us, irrespective of our circumstances. We read Isaiah chapter 41 and verse 10 that talks about the fact that God's promise for us is to strengthen us and all of that. And then we now said, so what are the things and how do we respond? How do we deal with the issues we are contending with? Number one, we said that we need to stay the course. Don't deviate even when things don't seem right. Stay the course. Don't give up. Just stay there. Maintain. Secondly, we said we should rejoice in hope. Don't let the devil steal your joy. The moment the devil steals your joy, you go into depression. And the antidote to depression is the joyful heart. The Bible says, a merry heart maketh good like medicine. So you need to be joyous, you need to be joyful, you need to maintain, even if it's difficult. And I know it's difficult, but don't let the devil steal your joy. Number three, we said that you must then reach out to others that might be going through. Share love, share and be a blessing to them, and be a blessing in going to be a blessing to somebody, in sharing and encouraging somebody, you also get encouragement. Praise the Lord. So number four thing this morning we're going to talk about, and is part of that, is that you must maintain your confession. You must maintain your confession. And I've titled speaking very broadly, how to do that is looking at the power that is unleashed in the tongue. James chapter 3, unfortunately, I don't know what's wrong this morning. It's been having this recurring problem, and so because I was hoping that we could project so many versions, so I have to rely on the James chapter 3, verse 1 to 12, but I'd like to read NIV because I love the way it is said there. So permit me to read. If you have NIV or CEV, NIV is New International Translation, CEV is Contemporary English Version. Those two versions, I love the way they are said. It's rendered. James chapter 3, verse 1 to 12, NIV or CEV, but if you don't have that, read your KJV, it's okay. James chapter 3, verse 1 to 12. Not many of you should become teachers, my fellow believers, because you know that we who teach would be judged more strictly. We all stumble in many ways. Anyone who is never at fault in what they say is perfect, able to keep their own body in check. Anyone who is never at fault in what they say is perfect, able to keep their own body in check. When we put bits into the mouths of horses to make them obey us, we can turn the whole animal. Or take sheep as an example. Although they are so large and driven by strong winds, they are steered by a very small rudder wherever the pilot wants to go. Likewise, the tongue is a small part of the body, but it makes great push. Consider what a great forest is set on fire by a small spark. The tongue also is a fire, a world of evil among the parts of the body. It corrupts the whole body, sets the whole course of one's life on fire, and is itself set on fire by hell. Verse 7. All kinds of animals, birds, reptiles, and sea creatures are being tamed, and have been tamed by mankind. But no human being can tame the tongue. It is a restless evil, full of deadly poison. With the tongue, we praise our Lord and Father. And with it, we curse human beings who have been created in God's likeness. Out of the same mouth come praise and cursing. My brothers and sisters, this should not be. Can both fresh water and salt water flow from the same spring? My brothers and sisters, can a fig tree bear olives or a grapevine bear figs? Neither can a salt spring produce fresh water. Praise the Lord. So, reading this place will establish something about the tongue. It is the most powerful organ of the body. In terms of the ability to sustain life otherwise, we'll see it. So, if we understand the power of the tongue, we will be careful to make sure that that is used positively. That's why I said that. Sustaining your positive confession. I have I said the remote control of the body is the tongue. You know, if you want to control a TV or any other stuff, you just hold it and you're pressing, you know. The same way, if you are going to control your body, you must be able to control the tongue. Inability to control the tongue, you are not able to control the body. Even when the body is going to lust, it starts from the tongue, it starts from your mouth. Yes, the eye will see a lady and all of that, lust after it, but you will use your mouth to say stuff to the lady. Do you just go and meet a woman and just go and start sleeping with her? You will talk, you open your mouth and say something. Even if the eye is lusting after the woman, but if the mouth is able to keep quiet and not say anything, you will survive that lust. To steal, your mouth will say something. So, everything you think about that is a negativity, the mouth is a contributor to it. Even when you are conceiving stuff, what if you conceive stuff in your heart, if you conceive negativity in your heart, if you don't voice it out, most likely you will not cry it out. The remote control of the body is the tongue. If you are able to control the tongue, you are able to control the whole body. Now look at that. Verse 2 in CEV. Let me. The Contemporary English Version, verse 2. That's James chapter 3, verse 2. Look at it in Contemporary English Version. All of us do many wrong things. But if you can control your tongue, you are mature and able to control your whole body. If you can control your tongue, you are mature and able to control your whole body. If you can just control your tongue, if you are able to ensure that your tongue is tamed, then you move to maturity, you're able to control your body, you're able to take charge. So as we look at the things around us and challenging us and all the challenges you have to deal with, the most important thing that you need to be sure about is that make sure, let me quiet on myself, make sure that what comes out of your mouth is not contrary, because once contrary comes out of your mouth, you can never get out of that situation. Because everything that, in terms of faith, in terms of everything, you will nullify it in a day by a negative confession. If you are sick and you say, I'm going to die of this sickness, let Daddy Gio come and pray for you, you'll die. Irrespective, if you are going through a challenge and you use your mouth to say this is what is going to kill me, I'll never come out of it, you have sealed your faith. You see, show you scripture. You know, I don't say stuff without establishing scriptures. So that is why it says that. But if you can control your tongue, you are mature, you're able to control your whole body. Pastor, I say it the way I feel it. Don't say the way you feel it, because you are ensnared by the words of your mouth. Don't say it the way you feel it. But Pastor, am I going to lie? Yes, you want to lie. If you say it's lying, but it's not lying. Because the Bible says that let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich. So you confess what you want, not how you are feeling. You confess what you want, not how you are feeling. If you confess how you are feeling, I feel so depressed. I feel like a non-entity. I feel like nobody cares about me. I feel like that is exactly how it will be. 12 spies were sent to go and spy the land. 10 came back and said to Moses, Moses, we went to the land. The land indeed flowed with milk and honey. In fact, look at the fruits of the land. But there's a but. It says that we saw the sons of Anak. We were in our own eyes like grasshoppers. So were we in their eyes. The first of all said, we were in our own eyes like grasshoppers. So were we. So, they said that we saw ourselves as grasshopper, and that's how they saw us. And the 10 decided that it was not possible to conquer the land. And of course, as you have spoken in my ears, so, but Caleb and Joshua stilled the people and said, we are well able, for their strength is gone, for our God is able to deliver it. The sons of Anak, naturally speaking, they were giants, they were huge. But you see, it is the confession that brings the faith. It is the declaration and the mouth. So when you are going through what you are going through, and irrespective of what you are having to deal with, the power of confession. The tongue is a gateway through which the thoughts of the heart, the impressions in the mind, and the feelings and emotions are released or expressed. If you feel love, you will say it. If you feel hatred, you say it, right? But you are learning today that what comes out of your mouth should be the positive. The tongue is the gateway through which the thoughts of the heart, what you are thinking, the impressions in your mind, what is in your mind, and your emotions, it is through the mouth that you give expression to it. You know, with due respect to ladies, men, we normally, but we action people, don't normally talk. I don't know, ladies, married men in the house, I'm sure you can relate with this. When you say that, do you love me? But you know I love you. Why did you say it? I remember this word, this couple word, used to be in the King's Chamber, Pastor. Now, the wife served the man food and he demolished it. So the white man said, do you like the food? I think so. So why did you say, but I demolished the food? Isn't that evidence that I like it? That I demolished it? Is that what you should have said it? So women like say it. But you should know by the fact that more should show you that I enjoy the food. But the woman is not, that's not enough. Say it. Say that you enjoy the food. So women are like that, right? The same way, make sure you keep your your confession. Make sure you say it. Say it. Faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word. Faith is built up by the things you confess. I'm still coming there, but you know, just going ahead of myself. So, the tongue is the gateway through which the thoughts of the heart are expressed. So, what is going through your mind, make sure that it is a positive at the end of the day. The very popular scripture that we know, and I'd like to read it in NLT. Proverbs 18 and verse 21. I would love to read it in NLT. Proverbs 18:21. NLT. Sorry, I was trying to navigate. But just these ways, these things hit you very hard. Proverbs 18:21. The tongue can bring death or life. KJV says that death and life lies in the power of the tongue. NLT says the tongue can bring death or life. Those who love to talk will reap the consequences. The tongue can bring death or life. So I said there, I said the tongue could be the decider if a person will experience life or death. And that's why I said to you, if you say motikuo, that is it. You have brought death with your mouth, your tongue. You have brought death. Maybe the mercy of God will be available, but it will really have to be the mercy of God. Because even the accuser of brethren will go and tell God that the man said he wants to die. What's your own God? In fact, the man said he's dead, not that I want to die, but you cool. So, God, why are you stressing yourself? The man said he's dead. So, the tongue, he says that the tongue can bring death or life. Let me read NIV. The tongue has the power of life and the power of death. So which one do you want to manifest? The tongue has the power of life, the power of death. Going back to that James chapter 3, and reading the CV, reading it in the Contemporary English Translation, look at verse 6. James chapter 3, verse 6, CV says, The tongue is like a spark, it is an evil power that dirties the rest of the body and sets a person's entire life on fire with flames that come from hell itself. The tongue is like a spark. You know, if you want to burn the whole of this place, as big as this place is, just take one match, one single stick, strike and put it on this cloth or look for paper. You don't even need petrol. Just one stick, as big as this whole building is, one stick, just strike and put here. By the time it burns the drum, burns like that, burns everywhere. Give it 1 hour, the whole building is down. One stick. You don't need the whole box of matches. One stick. So he says that the tongue is like that. The tongue is like a spark. One negative word out of your mouth can set your whole body on fire. That's what that place is saying. It says that the tongue is like a spark. It's an evil power that dirties the rest of the body. So if you like to speak foul languages, if you like to speak negativities, you are dirtying the whole body. You render useless all the sermon of pastor. You render useless all the prayer of Minister Adeyanju. You render useless everything that has ever you've ever come across, because you have allowed your tongue to spark. So that's why you need to be careful when you are going through, when you're having to deal with these issues. Yes, pastor, you don't know what I'm going through. I may not know, and truly I may not know. You may be dealing with things that are way bigger than the one I'm dealing with. I agree with you. But I give you this morning a secret that irrespective of what you are going through, be careful of your confession. Because if you make negative confessions, you have sealed it. You have sealed the heavens over you. You cannot allow God to penetrate through you. So don't compound your problem by negative confession. Don't use your mouth to spell your own doom. At the very worst, keep quiet. If you can't confess negative, keep quiet. Rishon Mugi. But if you start to say, Nigeria scatter, scatter, Nigeria jaga, jaga, all of us are dead. You want them to die. Oh, this price of this, we can't afford rice again. We'll have to be drinking Gary. As you have said in your mouth, you just find out you can't buy rice anymore. Oh, this school fees, I'm not able to pay it. It's so exorbitant, I'll never be able to pay the school fees. So see your student drop out of school. Oh, this diabetes, this my high BP. It was what killed my father, killed my grandfather. I think it might kill me. So if you cannot confess positive, do what? The tongue is a spark. It can cause irreparable damage. Proverbs chapter 6 and verse 2. Go back to good old KJV. Proverbs chapter 6 and verse 2. Thou art snared with the words of thy mouth. Thou art taken with the words of your mouth. You are trapped. KJV says instead, you are trapped. You are caught in. You are etched in by the words of your mouth. Thou art snared with the words of thy mouth. And thou art taken by the words of your mouth. So it is what you say that explains you, that traps you. So be careful not to trap yourself with negative confessions. Be careful not to trap yourself with negative confessions. Be careful not to trap yourself with negative confession. No matter how difficult it is, no matter how challenging it is, I know, I can relate to the fact that it's difficult, it's challenging, but you owe yourself the duty not to confess negative. This useless man. Oh, Lushiloni Buruku. See, now so all your mates they do. That man can never do you good. He will never be able to do you. Even if he tries, you have sealed it. You have snapped it off your mouth. But Pastor, the man beat me blue, black, and yellow. Why should I say anything good about him? Then they show me. You can't bless him. Keep quiet. But if you open your mouth and use abusive words, those things you said about him, useless man, you will ever remain useless. See, this is my wife. She doesn't even know how to cook. Let her go to the best cookery book or whatever it is. She will never know how to cook. So be careful. Be careful. You're a dullard. See your classmates. I went to your school. See all your mates. See what the teacher said about them. You now play. You know how to play. You are never. That child will never make it. It's not a curse. You have brought it upon the child with your own mouth. So be careful, because you are snared by the words of your own mouth. Luke chapter 19 and verse 22. Very popular scripture as well. Now, this is a parable of the talents, and this man was given one talent, and the guy went to go and hide it and said, you know, you are a very tough man, I don't want your trouble, so I've hidden your talent. And look at what the master said back to the man, verse 22. And the master said unto him, out of your own mouth I will judge you, wicked servant. You have used your mouth to say I'm a wicked or Gabi, no problem. Since you have said I'm wicked now, I will show you wickedness. Out of your own mouth I will judge you, wicked servant. So be careful. Words coming out of your mouth can be used to judge you. Be careful. The words that come out of your mouth can be words that will exactly be used to, judge you.
Sister, I know you. You sow where you don't reap. You did it, you do that. So, oh God, take your talent. But I don't want your wahala. And the master said, okay, you have said with your mouth that I sow where I do not reap. I'm wicked. I will show you wickedness. Says, and he said to them that stood by, take from him the pound and give to them that have ten. And then he said that, but my enemies which know that I should reign over them, bring them hither and slay them. So that wicked servant was like, why? Because of the things he said. If he had kept quiet and just give your God his money, maybe he says, but he says that you sow, that you reap where you do not sow. You're a wicked man. Call the servant, you call your God wicked. What do you expect from me? Show you wickedness now. Show you shaking. So be careful. You need to move a bit faster now. Deuteronomy chapter 1 and verse 34. Deuteronomy. We are talking about the power of the tongue and the need for positivity. Deuteronomy 1, 34 and 35. And the Lord heard the voice of your words, and was wroth and swear, saying, surely there shall not one of these men of this evil generation see that good land which I swear to give unto your father. And the Lord heard the voice of your words. You murmured against me, I heard, and I was wroth, and because of that I swore that surely not one of you of this evil generation shall enter that good land. J.P. said that it is a land that is full of the sons of Anak that were not well able. Okay, since you say you are not well able, you don't go enter now. And the Lord had the voice of your word. So be careful. Be careful what's coming out of your mouth can condemn you and can deny you your inheritance. Because these guys were meant to enter into their promise, like enter into their inheritance, but because of the voice coming out of their mouth, because then I heard the voice of your words, and I was wroth with you, and I swore. If I wanted to have mercy, now I have sworn that surely not one of these men of this evil generation shall see the good land which I swore to their fathers. The careful words coming out of your mouth can deny you your inheritance. Look at Ezekiel 35, same thing. But they said differently. Ezekiel 35 verse 12. Ezekiel 35, 12 to 14. And thou shalt know that I am the Lord, and that I have heard all thy blasphemies which thou hast spoken against the mountains of Israel, saying, they are laid desolate, they are giving us to consume. So you said you blaspheme and said that the mountain of Israel is laid desolate. Look at verse 13. Thus, with your mouth, you have boasted against me and have multiplied your words against me. I have had them. Verse 14. Thus said the Lord, when the whole earth rejoiced, I will make the word desolate. You have said with your mouth that Israel is desolate. That same thing you said is what I'm going to make of you. Be careful not to use your mouth to deny yourself of your destiny or your inheritance. It says, I have heard your blasphemies. You spoke against Mount Israel, mountains of Israel. You said that they are laid desolate. Thus, when everybody else is rejoicing, when everybody else is entering into their prosperity, you will be what? Desolate. So you use your mouth to call desolate, you receive desolate. That's why I told you, be careful, be extremely careful, the things you say with your mouth. So when things are difficult and things are tough, if you feel bad, you feel pain, you feel all those things, just keep quiet. Better not to say anything than to say negativities. I love this. Proverbs chapter 10 and verse 19. And I love the way it is said in NLT. Proverbs chapter 10 and verse 19. Let me read NLT to you.
Proverbs 10, 19 NLT. Too much talk leads to sin. Be sensible and keep your mouth shut. Too much talk leads to sin. Be sensible and keep your mouth shut. Too much talk. Because in the talk, one, there might be embellishment, exaggeration, lies, and that brings sin. Or the other way around, in the too much talk, is you say things you ought not to say and you are going to offend God because you operate from a heart of ingratitude. What have you done for me lately? God, see, even pastor is shining. I mean, I'm not shining. You don't know whether pastor is old dog mercy. You go and say stuff that you ought not to say, and you grieve God. It says that too much talk is to say, be sensible and keep your mouth shut. Don't say things that you should not say. Talk. Jeez, that's why sometimes I tell people that be careful. It's not as if, but I don't want to know too many things, because wanting to know too many things, you'll be, before you know it, you know, you bring stuff that I don't want to know. I don't want to just, they say innocence is what? Please, let me just not know. Because if you are not careful, you will say stuff that you ought not to say. The children of Israel cut short their destiny by murmuring and by complaining. 1 Corinthians chapter 10 and verse 10. Neither murmur, as some of them also murmured, and because of their murmuring, they were destroyed of the destroyer. Neither murmur ye, as some of them did, because of their murmuring, they were destroyed of the destroyer. I know that things are tough, things are difficult, that's why I started from, remember, that we're all going through. But even though we're all going through challenges, even though things are tough and things are difficult, even though truly, you are pressed beyond measure, even though truly, you have not had a job for so long, even though truly, a bro has refused to show up, even all of these things are real, yeah? But please be careful not to enter into the murmuring mode. Be careful not to activate the murmuring mode. If you enter into the murmuring mode, God will just step aside and the destroyer will step in. It says, and they were destroyed by the destroyer. And God stood aloof. Look at what they murmured. Exodus chapter 14. Verse 11, verse 12. Because when the writer of the letter to the Corinthians, Paul said they murmured, what was their murmuring? Exodus chapter 14, verse 11 and verse 12. Exodus 14, 11 and 12. So in Exodus, remember that they were out of Egypt, they were already, you know, on the way to the promised land. Then, because now the Egyptians were now pursuing them. And they said unto Moses, is it because there are no graves in Egypt that you are taking us away to die in the wilderness? He said, I told you that be careful what you say, because everything you say that is negative, the devil will come and amplify it. Here, they were facing the Red Sea. Yeah, so there was a challenge, truly. Right? But instead of them to say to Moses, my faith, no fit carry am, how we go take cross this into another? They said with their mouth that is it because there is no grave in Egypt that you have brought us to die in the wilderness. What happened to them? They died in the wilderness. Not one of these ones saw and entered the promised land. Be careful what you say. Is it because there is no grave in Egypt that you brought us and have taken us to die in the wilderness? Wherefore hast thou dealt with us to carry us forth out of Egypt?
Is it not the word that we did tell you in Egypt, saying, let us alone that we serve the Egyptian? For it is better for us to serve the Egyptians than we should die in the wilderness. And they remain in servitude. And that is why they were always being oppressed. They were always being carried into captivity. Then the Lord will come deliver them. They will be carried into captivity because they said to themselves that they want to be slaves. So be careful. So God was wroth, but did you not see the 10 plagues? Is that not enough evidence? If I did it, that the whole of Egypt lost their firstborn, but you guys, you didn't lose your own. Is that not a miracle to show you that I'm able to deliver you? Or if that was not enough for you guys, your mom would have been okay. Okay. And that's what led to that Numbers chapter 14, verse 27 and 28 that we now know. Numbers 14, 27 and 28. How long shall I bear with this evil congregation? Which murmur against me? God is against murmurers. Please, if you help yourself today, make sure you do not activate the murmuring mode. Hello? Please, make sure. Because what you are doing is that you are challenging God by murmuring. You are telling God that, yes, you did it yesterday, but you can't do it again today. But murmuring, you are saying, God, yes, now, you made me pass my exam last year, but this time around I feel, so you feel like, say, your power, no, you don't get power again. That is what murmuring does. Murmuring is challenging God. That is why he says, he stepped aside, allow the destroyer to destroy them. When you murmur, you are challenging the ability of God to come through for you. When you murmur, you are saying to God, I'm not sure that you are still God. I'm not sure you are still capable of delivering me. You see, those three places you've read, it says that, how long will I bear with this evil congregation? Which murmur against me? I have had the murmurings of the children of Israel, which they murmur against me. Say unto them, because of this murmuring, as truly as I live, say the Lord, as you have spoken my ears, so will I do unto you. You want to die in the wilderness? You will die in the wilderness. You want to remain slaves? You remain slaves. Because that is what you said. Please, I beg of you in the name of the Lord. We are all going through. Hello? We are all going through. We are all facing real life challenges. Insecurity is telling everybody, nobody is safe. Forget about people living in where is the most secure place they might think. Only go, you forget it. All of us are facing insecurity. All of us are facing, we go to the market, the price of food is just going up anyhow. I wanted to do some repair work in my house. I said, oh God, give me a quote now. For over 2 weeks now, the guy said, I'm sorry, I can't give you a quote. Every time I go to the market, the price is going up. So if I give you a quote now, and you know, says every time I go to the market, the price of materials are just going up. So we all face that. We all know. But the worst thing you can do for yourself is to murmur. The worst thing you can do for yourself is to murmur, because you'll be destroyed of the destroyer. Be careful. Be careful. Don't challenge God. Don't ever challenge God's sovereignty or his ability to show for you. He has proven it before. He will prove it again. Like I told you, if you cannot confess positive, just keep quiet. You are better off keeping quiet than expressing your frustration, your anger, whatever it is. God does not tolerate it. Because you are, after he has said to you, you will still see all his promises. We are coming there. I still have time. We are still going to all his promises. When he has said to you, I will never leave you nor forsake you. So when you murmur, you are saying, God, I don't think that you can do that. You say you will not leave me nor forsake me, but God, you don't leave me today. Don't forsake me. Okay? You say, I've left you, I've forsaken you. Right? No problem. Words are backed up by spirit beings. When you speak words, the spirit behind the words goes to perform them. I will give you three scriptures. When you make a declaration, either positive or negative, the spirit behind the words, go to perform them. Isaiah chapter 55 and verse 11. Well, let's start from Jeremiah. Jeremiah chapter 1 and verse 12. I love the way it said in NIV. Let me read it for you. Jeremiah. Jeremiah chapter 1 and verse 12. Jeremiah 1:12. The Lord said to me, you have seen correctly, for I am watching to see that my word is fulfilled. I am taking interest to make sure that my word is fulfilled. KJV says, I watch over my words to perform it. I am watching over my word to ensure that it is fulfilled. So there's a spirit backing up the word. So when I speak the word, I'm watching my words. I'm watching my words to make sure it comes to pass. I am watching to see that my word is fulfilled. So there's a spirit to enforce the performance of those words. Isaiah 55 and verse 11. Very familiar. So shall my word be that goeth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void. It shall accomplish that which I please. It shall prosper in the things wherein I God sent it. So shall my word, if my word cannot return void. So when God speaks a word, be rest assured that it will hit target. Except you counter it with your own negative words. In which case, God says, well, I can't help you. John 6:63. It is a spirit that quickens. The flesh has no profit. The words that I speak unto you, they are spirit, they are life. Words that I speak, once it comes out of my mouth, so shall my word be that proceed out of my mouth. Once it goes out, it becomes spirit. So once you say mobeo, potiku, the spirit behind mobe comes to manifest. Once you say motiku, the spirit of death is activated. The words that I speak, they are spirit, they are life. So, are you speaking positive words? Very quickly, because of time. So, what is to be done to tame the tongue? What should you do? When all of this are happening, what should you do? Number one, place a padlock on your mouth. Just don't look for a padlock. Go and look for a big padlock. Just padlock your mouth. Yeah. That's what you have to do. Rather than if you can't confess positive, rather than confess negative and go and scatter what God has destined for you, just place a padlock there. Psalm 141:3. Psalm 141:3. Psalm 141:3. Set a watch, O Lord, before my mouth. Keep the door of my lips. Set a watch. It is a padlock. Just go and buy padlock. Go to the market. Go and buy padlock. Look at them. This thing, it looks like joke, but that is the antidote to your not cutting short your destiny. So, what, even though I'm speaking figuratively, what it means is that just keep your mouth shut. Just cultivate the habit of not talking. Just cultivate the habit of not talking. They say you'll be mumu. Yes, I'll be mumu. Just keep quiet. Just keep quiet. Don't talk. You are better off not talking, because any attempt to talk, if you say negative, don't enter. So when people come and say, petrol price, they say they don't come on subsidy. Now 500 naira now, if you see these people, you know, I will never, that means I won't be driving again. Now, once you say that you'll be driving again, you will park your car, you won't be able to afford it. So rather than join them to say that, just, even though in your heart you are feeling the heart, that is the fear you have. But I told you that the voice is the gateway. So if you don't voice it out, it is in your heart, not the problem. But the moment you say, it's true, they've removed subsidy. 500 naira, how can I afford 500 naira? That means I won't drive again. That your car is permanently parked. So When they come, just keep quiet. Ah, can you imagine? They remove something. Da-da-da-da-da-da. Don't join them to say that you cannot buy. When petrol was 80 something, we buy it. Now, if I can't, I don't, you know, I'm saying this before God, I'm not trying to boast. I actually do not have an idea what the pump price is. Because I know some people from 162, 163, 162.5, depending on the petrol station you go to, they are doing those manipulations. But because I would rather deal with the source than keep myself with a problem. I would rather that God, I have been young, now I'm old. I have not seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. I would rather that scripture, confess that scripture, and say, Lord, it manifest, O God. And if I cannot confess that scripture, I'll keep quiet. Even if I'm going to put my car down, I will not use my own mouth to say, I'm going to park my car. Because that is the fastest way by which it will happen. Once you say that, 500 naira per liter, I can't afford it again. So, place a padlock in your mouth. Let me move a bit faster now. I've got just 10 minutes to go. Do not, so you see that in Psalm 141 verse 3. Do not speak foul or contrary words. Be careful the words that you speak. Don't speak words that are negative. Rather, speak positive words. Ephesians chapter 4 and verse 29. Ephesians 4:29. Let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth. Don't let corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth. Don't let anything negative come out of your mouth. Let me read, simpler translation so that you can get the gist. Do not let any unwholesome talk come out of your mouth, but only what is helpful for building others up according to their needs, that it may benefit those who listen. Do not let any unwholesome talk, any dirty talk, any negative word come out of your mouth. So make sure that you don't speak foul or contrary words. Be careful the words that you speak. Colossians chapter 3 and verse 8. Colossians 3, 8. But now you also put off these things: anger, wrath, malice, blasphemy, and filthy communication out of your mouth. Put out filthy communication. Number three, what are the things you should do to be able to, tame your tongue? Number three, meditate. Ponder before you speak. Meditate. Ponder. Think through. Consider before you open your mouth to speak. Psalm 19 and verse 14. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart. It is the words that is coming out of the meditation of your heart that is acceptable in the sight of the Lord. It is words that are coming out of a heart that is meditating, not just speak at the spur of the moment. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in the sight. So ponder, pause, meditate, think through. Don't say stop before you say, okay, I didn't mean it. No, careful. Nobody's putting a gun to your head. Don't talk. Don't be hasty to talk. Be hasty to think before you talk. Number four, don't speak idle words, because you give account for every idle word. Matthew chapter 12 and verse 36. Matthew chapter 12 and verse 36. But I say unto you, that every idle word that men shall speak, they shall give account thereof in the day of judgment. Every idle word, just speak carelessly. I know some of us are good at that. Just talk anyhow. This talk anyhow will land you into trouble. Don't talk anyhow. Don't just talk bow. Just say most of most. No. Don't talk anyhow. Please do your tongue. Put a padlock in your mouth. Because if you talk idle talk, you give account of them. Number five, okay, time. Don't be quick to speak. Keep quiet more. Don't speak. Rather than wanting to speak, try to keep quiet. Try to listen or try to calm down the more. Look at Proverbs chapter 17. I love this. Proverbs chapter 17, verse 27 and verse 28. Proverbs 17, 27, 28. Proverbs 17, 27, 28. He that hath knowledge spareth his words. A man of understanding is of an excellent spirit. Even a fool, when he owns his peace, is counted wise, and he that shorteth his lips is esteemed a man of understanding. Do you understand that? Let me tell you what this place is saying. This place is saying that even a fool that doesn't know what to say, or that doesn't have anything to say, because he keeps quiet, you'll think what is a wise man. So they ascribe wisdom to people that talk merely, because they consider that you are weighing the things before you talk. He that had knowledge spareth his words. Doesn't speak, a man of knowledge doesn't speak by his spear. He speaks sparingly. He that hath knowledge spareth his words. A man of understanding is of an excellent speech. Even a fool, when he holdeth his peace, is counted wise. And he that shorteth his lips is esteemed a man of understanding. He that shorts his lips, that doesn't talk, is considered a man of understanding. The same thing is said in Proverbs 21:23. Whoso keepeth his mouth and his tongue keepeth his soul from trouble. If you keep your mouth, you are keeping yourself from trouble. That's why I said to you, be careful. Don't be busybody. Some of us, matter that don't concern us, we want to choke mouth. By choking mouth, you are injuring your soul. You know, some people, they, you know, only told you body and no pamo, that's not their case. Once they see, they must talk. Why must you talk? Everything that you see must talk. You are injuring your soul. Engage in positive confession. We saw that in Ephesians chapter 4, verse 29. Let no evil communication proceed out of your mouth, but that which is good for the edification, that it may minister grace unto the hearers. Engage in positive confession. The most effective way to neutralize all the negatives is to engage in the positive. Positive confession helps to boost your faith and confidence in God's ability to perform what He says He will do. When you speak, when you make positive confession, what you are doing is that you are boosting your own faith and confidence. You are saying that, God, I know you are too faithful to fail me. I know that you come true for me. So those confessions that you're making is helping you to stay positive. Once you have a positive mindset, a positive attitude, you are able and better able to deal with life issues. If you have a positive mindset, a positive attitude, a positive outlook, you are able to deal with issues better than somebody who is negative. So the same set of scenario, same issue you are all facing. You have not eaten since yesterday, both of you. But if you are in the murmuring mode, you have invited the destroyer. But if you are in thankful mode, you have invited God. Lord, I thank you because I have not eaten since yesterday. You are likely to draw God than God. That's why you look me so. You know, since my children never chop. If you are in the murmuring mode, you will remain in that state. It's not a cause. You will call it by yourself. So, it's back to Him. And I have quite a lot here, but time will not permit us because I'm mindful of time. Give God back His word. So when you are faced with those issues, remind God of His words. God, that this is what your word says. And it is a confession. That's why we do those positive confessions. That's why we always have a scripture. We don't just write stuff. It is tied to a scripture because we are saying, God, this is what your word says, and we are giving it back to you. So every day, the daily positive confession is a word in the Bible that says, God, this is what your word says, by giving it back to you, let it manifest in me. So when you are feeling inadequate, or you are feeling, you know, as if you can't do it, as if, you know, you are inadequate, declares Philippians 4:13, I can do all things through Christ, strengthens me. So when a sense of inadequacy falls through you, confess it. I can do all things. And before you know it, faith and hope arises in you. When you are feeling as though you are short of supplies, when you are feeling as though, you know, you are running out of supplies, declare Philippians chapter 1 verse 19. But my God shall supply all my needs according to his riches in glory in Christ Jesus. Make those confessions. When you are feeling sick, and you are feeling pain in your body, declare 1 Peter chapter 2 and verse 24. For he himself in his body took away my infirmities. By his stripes I was, past tense, healed. When you are feeling frustrated, when you are feeling as though life in itself is not fair to you, remember the image of 29 and verse 11. For I know the thoughts that I have towards you, thoughts of good and not of you, to give you a future and an expected end. You declare unto him. When you are feeling lost and you are feeling as if there's, you can't find your way, you know, remember Psalm 23 and verse 1. For the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. When you are feeling overwhelmed and as though everything is just falling upon you and going to swallow you, remember Isaiah chapter 15 and verse 2. He says that when you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and through the fire it will not kindle against you. You confess the words of God back unto him. When you're overwhelmed and you feel as though, I'm not sure I can carry it anymore, and I'm not sure that, you know, I'm burdened with all these cares, remember 1 Peter chapter 5 and verse 7. Cast all your cares upon him, for he cared for you. We read the scriptures. That's why we do DPC. Read all the scriptures and begin to keep God's word back unto him. So rise up on our feet. So the positive confession removes the negativity. The confession that you declare based on the word of the Lord is what will counter. Pastor, I'm going through. Even pastor himself is going through. But what keeps pastor going? Why is pastor able to stand before you to preach today? Is that pastor is also practicalizing these things. He's also saying that even though there are needs that are staring in place and they're looking almost as if this need, if I don't meet it, but I'm saying that I know that my God shall supply all my needs according to his riches in Christ Jesus. He said, I'm saying and declaring the word of the Lord back to him. In Matthew 11, 28 and verse 30, when you feel pressure, says that, come unto me, all ye that labor and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. I'm drawing on the rest of God, because God is able to give me rest. So I want you to open your mouth and make positive confessions. What are you facing? What is facing you? What is challenging you? What is that thing that the devil is, you know, using to torment you? What is the thing that the devil is using to harass you? Go to the word of God and use the word of God and counter it. Beat it with your positive confession. Is the devil tell you that, you are approaching menopause, how far with you? Tell him that the Bible says, I will serve the Lord my God. He will bless my bread, he will bless my water. He says that no will be sick and no will be barren. The number of my days says you fulfill. No will cast his yoke. Is the devil telling you that you can't make it? Or that you are $2? Tell the devil that the Bible says that I have understanding more than my teachers. So open your mouth and give the word of God back to him, and tell the devil that he's lost the battle where you're concerned. Lord, you are the glory and the lift of our heads, O God. Even in this situation, even in this circumstance, even when there are stories from the Lord, we choose to confess positive. We choose to declare positive. We choose to declare your word. We bring your word back unto you, O God. We remind you of your words. We remind you of your words. Zaleboshki, Zalabadoshki. Sihake diza lota kila banda la balusia. Rama baba sete la boshia. We do away with murmuring. We do away with complaining. We do away, oh God, with every negativity.
We hold on to your word, O God. Your word of life and your word of promise. Thank you, Jesus.
To your word, according to your promises, I can stand secure. I've opened my heart, the truth that sets me free. According to your word, oh Lord,
God has used this morning to bring about the word of life. Let us stretch forth our hands that concerning today's word, that everything he's looking unto God for, God will supply all his needs in the mighty name of Jesus. That none of the words he has spoken today or expounded on will stand against him of judgment. That regardless of what he's going through, that he will maintain his confession. And what will be that confession? That God will surely come through for him at the end. For in Jesus' mighty name we are praying.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
It's offering time. It's offering time. Maintain your confession. It's offering time. Can we package our offering in our offering envelopes? We have two envelopes, the offering envelopes and the divine connection offering. If we have tithers in the house, let them package their tithes too in the tithe envelope. And as the basket is going round, let them drop the tithes in the basket. And the blessing of obedience for tithing will be their portion in the mighty name of Jesus. Can we lift up our offering envelopes? Father Lord, we thank you for the seed in our hands. You are the one that gives seed to the sower. Thank you for this seed. Father Lord, as we offer them as love offering back to you, accept us.
Amen.
Accept our offerings.
Amen.
Let them come before you like sweet smelling incense, holy and acceptable unto you. Have regard for us and these gifts that were brought to you as love offerings. We cannot repay you for everything you do in our lives, but this is just a token to show that we are really grateful. Let it come back to us in many folds, pressed down, shaking together, and running over. For in Jesus' mighty name we are praying.
Amen.
Let us cheerfully give our offerings without compulsion.
I'm chasing after you. No matter what I have to do, I need you more and more. I'm chasing after you. No matter what I have to do, I need you more and more. More and more. More and more.
we have anyone worshiping with us for the first time? Okay, if we have anyone online worshiping with us for the first time, you are welcome. This is the King's Chamber, the Citadel of Favor. We are located in the Lekki Axis, Ikate, Elegushi. Oh, we have, oh, you're welcome. So sorry. Everyday life and living. So you're welcome, and you have been handed a token from the pastorate. Inside it is a little piece of paper. There's a pen there as well. You should fill your details. If you have any prayer requests, you can write it on that sheet of paper as well. And after service, you can just come to any of these seats and sit down. A counselor would come and meet with you. And if you have any questions or any specific inquiry, the counselor would answer your question. You are welcome once again. Praise the Lord. You may be seated. Yeah. So, can we listen to the following announcements? Our Sunday services, as usual, are 9 a.m., both online and on-site. And you're welcome to join us. If you are in the Lekki Axis, we are at 42 Obayekini Elegushi Road in Ikate, Lekki area. And if you are online, you are welcome to join us 9 a.m. prompt as Sunday services begin. Praise the Lord. On Wednesdays, we have our Bible study services, and our Wednesday services start at 6 p.m. You can join us on site as well, or online at via Facebook or Instagram. Our Facebook and Instagram pages. Our services are online. The Bible study. We break communion as well during our Wednesday services, and we would really enjoin you to join us on site. Praise the Lord. Come next Sunday, the 30th of May, our children will be taking over our Sunday service. It's going to be our Children's Day service, and everything in righteousness will be done by our lovely children. So join us online and on site too, and be blessed as you do in Jesus' name. On that same 30th of May at 5 p.m., we'll be having our usual ministry program, the Settle Me, O Lord program. It's a ministry of our Father and the Lord, and the program takes place at our headquarters in Ilupeju, 42 Association Avenue, Ilupeju by Obanikoro bus stop. And you can also join online if you are far away from Ilupeju via Facebook. Settle Me, O Lord is the Facebook page, all small letters. Praise the Lord. And come the month of June, we're having our traditional dress down Sunday. Praise the Lord. The last Sunday in June. It's gonna be, everything good in righteousness will happen that day. Come in your traditional attire, and let us, those tribes and tongues may differ, let us come together and worship God during this special service. Praise the Lord. So if you've not joined the group, we will have ministrations in Igbo, Hausa, Yoruba, and even the minority languages, no one is left out. We are all children of God, and God loves us equally. Praise the Lord. So join us at the last Sunday in June for this special Sunday service. May you be blessed as you do, in Jesus' name. All workers are to wait behind after service for a brief meeting. So immediately after service, just let's arrange ourselves, and a brief meeting will take place. And then after the workers' meeting, all women are further to wait behind for another brief meeting. So the men, you would indulge us. Praise the Lord. Have we been blessed? Praise the Lord. Praise Jesus.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Is it me or okay? My microphone was not sounding. Is it because I have the face mask on? Okay, so for the workers, I put what do you call it? I put a flyer on the workers forum. Is it today or yesterday?
Yesterday.
So there's this program. It's a PFA. Our Father in the Lord is invited as one of the speakers. He's somewhere on the mainland. So please, if you're interested in going, please see me. Particularly those of us that live in the mainland, if you want to go, please see me. We can make arrangements. Even if you stay on the island and you want to go, it's not a problem, please. Just, it's just that, I mean, since our Father in the Lord is ministering, it might be nice to also have some of us in attendance. Remember, Tuesday, not the day after tomorrow, next week Tuesday is 1st of June. Not two days time. Don't come here two days time. You don't meet anybody. Tuesday after two days time, it's 1st of June, and so we have our early morning settlement prayer here at 6 a.m. Please do remember early morning settlement prayer at next week Tuesday. As the Minister Ruki has announced, our traditional dress down day and traditional day, we need to begin to plan towards it. So what we've agreed, we're going to have to appoint sectional heads or ethnic heads so that we can have traction. Right now, people are just waiting for who will call who. So as from next Sunday, you guys will start to have your results. The Ubaji family are having their own family meeting outside. So again, everybody must participate. So as from next Sunday, the rehearsal must start. So get ready. All of you, start thinking about the songs you're going to take. It's going to be great. Please, for the Children's Day celebration next Sunday, I want to encourage us, as I think my wife has announced, if you have anything to support them, please do. You know, children, once you mention anything about them, it's party, you want to have fun. So money, Naim will require. So please, anything you can use to support, if you have a box of biscuit, carton of Indomie, that's Indomie. Okay, maybe they'll do that, take you in. I want to say capsule, biscuits, chocolate, and stuff like that. Yeah, so let's remember to do that. This announcement will be made. That's one of the reasons why the workers are waiting, but it's nice to announce it in the church so that everybody hears, then the workers will hear when we have. Femi Kuka, the son of the senior pastor, is getting married June 17th. In London. So the workers will give you full gist about that, but as a church member, your senior pastor's son is getting married, your own minimum responsibility is prayer. Your minimum responsibility is you pray that God should make those days, those events successful, and to be so in Jesus' name. Other information will be passing across to you. Today is world famous Mommy Papa's Day. So we are going to pray for this woman, great man of God. When you see Papa smiling, this is the source. This is the gateway to Papa smile. I'm going to go on our feet and just stretch your hand towards her, begin to rain blessings. Any blessing you want for yourself, any good thing you want for yourself, begin to pray. And declare, Lord, we pray for your daughter, and begin to release blessings, that in blessing the Lord will bless her, in multiplying the Lord will multiply her. The Lord will grant unto her all her heart desires. The
Lord will establish her. The Lord will favor her. The Lord will be good to her. She will not sorrow. Reasons to sorrow will never be a portion. She will never regret. She will not sit back and say, oh, 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 oh. That oh, 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 oh will never be a portion. She will never cry. Lift up your voice and pray. Listen, what will bring cry and tears to her eyes will never happen. The Lord will preserve her. Preserve her husband. Preserve her children. Preserve her business. Preserve our family, preserve everything that concerns us. As a mother, you know, I mean, I'm a father, so I know. As a mother, she has concerns over her children. That, hey, see my daughter, this one has finished. The next one now, the next one now, the next one now. Oh, well, this one has finished now. The other one remains. But this one, you know, all those things that a mother is planning and strategizing. Lord, as she's strategizing them, Lord. Lord, intervene on her behalf. As she's planning them, as she's thinking them, as she's praying for them, as she's saying, oh, Lord, see this my daughter, this level where she is now. Lord, help her to take up this level. As she's planning it and praying, Lord, establish it for her. As she's looking unto you, all of us are going through whatever it is that she may be going through herself. Lord, as she begins to confess you, Lord, show up for her, oh God. Make the way for her, oh God. Deliver her, oh God. Lift her up, oh God. Provide for her, oh God. Sustain her, oh God. Lift your parents and pray for herself. She's a virtuous woman. She will build her home. She will not scatter her home. The enemy will not come and uproot them. The joy that exists between her and her husband that we see and we are happy and we are glorifying God on their behalf. The enemy will not sow tears. The enemy will not use their children against them. The enemy will not come from outside and come and scatter good that the Lord has built, that they have built over this year, that they have built all this year. The enemy will not sow tears. The enemy will not scatter. Pray that the Lord will give her a special birthday package. This morning when she woke up, she must have said a prayer. Lord, what prayer she prayed to you, O God, and what she desires of you, O God, answer unto her speedily, O God. Grant her a special birthday package. Let her know that she's favored of you. Let her know that she's beloved of you. In the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you and we bless you, God. Pray that evil, calamity, disaster is not from her. As she goes out, as she comes back, insecurity, kidnappers, stray bullet, one chance, all this evil in the land will not be a portion. Will not be the portion of our loved one. We will never have any emergency over them. We will not run elder scatter over the Yireh family. Pray that their joy will be full in the name of Jesus. Leborishki, Leborishkiya, Labrasaka Toleboski, Leboriskiya, Rakisa Kula Bazedele, Leboroshki, La Simi Laboshka, Ratukoni Babaraka Segeleboshki, Linde Loboroskiya, La Pakuki Kaluka Ibaba. In Jesus. Mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
Father Lord, we rejoice with our dear mother, sister, who today has one year to her years that you, O God, have added to her. Lord, we have prayed for her. Every prayer that we have prayed in righteousness. Lord, I can instill to perform your word in her life. In the name of Jesus. Grant unto her a special birthday package, O God. Beyond what man can give her. Beyond money, beyond anything that man can give, you, O God, give unto her yourself in the name of Jesus. Where the shoe is pinching, where she still needs you to show, where at night she's still having, you know, those thoughts and saying, God, this thing, Lord, today, as a special birthday package, answer her heart, innermost heart desire in the name of Jesus. Grant that, O God, her heart desire. Over our husband, over our children, over our business, over our family, over our interest, over everything that concerns her in the name of Jesus. We cover her in the blood of Jesus. We cover her interest in the blood of Jesus. We decree, O God, that she is a child of God. She is a member of this great commission. The covenant of life, the covenant of safety and security will speak for her in the name of Jesus. She will not sorrow. Her head will never be bowed down in shame. She will never regret, O God. Rather, she will experience joy. Joy more and more and more in the name of Jesus. Go forth into the new year, rejoicing and prospering. And let the will of God be done in your life. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Let's sing for her.
May the good Lord bless you.
I think Ubati's father is this week. I think Ubati is 26. Huh? Just the wife is answering yes. I think someone is 27. Okay, I think you are 27. All right, praise the Lord. So many more celebrations. May children are unique and wonderful people. May, can we have a witness in the house? You are 28. You are May? You are joining us. You are allowed to put. Putting is allowed. Putting is allowed. Father, we thank you. Father, we bless you. Father, we praise you. Father, we worship you. Father, we adore you. We thank you for all the blessings that you have blessed us with and everything that you have done for us. We are grateful. Father, accept our hearts of gratitude. We thank you for teaching us and reminding us again to always breathe with our tongues. Father, we ask for your help, O God, that Lord, we will not make negative confessions to ruin the things you have been in life. Rather, we will continue to confess positive, even when things are difficult, even when things are hard, even when things are not looking as they should do. But we choose to believe you, and we choose to voice out our belief in you by those confessions in the name of Jesus. As we go, go before us, O God. Go with us, O God. Increase us on all sides. Enlarge our coast. Multiply us. Bless us. Fulfill your word and your purpose in our lives, O God. Let us continually rejoice. We pray for as many as are online. Let them also experience the same blessing that we have experienced. For as many as are able to join us, for whatever reason, O God, Lord, let them also encounter you in the name of Jesus. Lord, we are grateful. Lord, we appreciate you. Lord, we bless you. Lord, we worship you. Lord, we adore you. Thank you, because this week, O God, the last week in May, shall deliver abundant testimonies for us in the name of Jesus. Giving you praise, giving you glory, giving you honor and adoration in Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Shall we share the grace together? The love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be and abide with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever in Jesus' name. Amen. Psalm 16, verse 11. For the Lord will show us the path of life, on his presence there is fullness of joy, at his right hand there are pleasures forevermore. Shalom. The Lord bless you. Have a great week ahead of you.